Hello students, welcome you to the next tutorials on design of asynchronous sequential circuit. So a problem statement is given. Design a gated latch circuit with two inputs G and D and one output Q. The gated latch is a memory element that accepts the value of D when G is equal to 1. And retain this value after G goes to 0. Once G is equal to 0, a change in D does not have any change of the value in the output. So this is the problem statement given for the pulse mode operation of a asynchronous sequential circuit. So in identifying the problem statement, we already know the steps to be followed is obtain the primitive flow table, reduce the flow table, assign the binary state table and obtain the transition table. Using K-maps, get the synthesized equation or a state equation. Finally, draw the logical diagram. So these are the steps we have to do it while defining a problem statement. So first is to obtain a flow table. So to obtain a flow table, we need to know what is the flow of the diagram, which is corresponding to the problem statement. Here we'll see G is taken as the latch input. It is fixed to value 1. First condition, when G is equal to 1. So the D can go either to, it's a D latch. Therefore, D can go to either 0 or 1. So, I'm going to write it in terms of DG is the input slash output. Input slash output. D is 0. Gate always remains at 1. The output will go to 0. That is the condition. Second, the D can go to 1. G is going to be fixed to 1. The output will go to 1. See the conditions. Similarly, now the gate is fixed to 0. Alternative condition, gate value is fixed to 0. D will go either 0 or 1. So the combination is 0, 0 or 1, 0. So 0, 1 output, 1, 1 output. So the combination which can make from here is it will go from 0, 1. This is your initial condition, correct? So from here it can go to 0, 0. It can go to 1, 0. Similarly, this can go to 1, 0 and this can go to 0, 0. So change the conditions according to the parameters. Now, whenever you change it, you take the output from the problem statement. So whenever G is 0, D is 0, output is 0. D is 1, output is 0 because G is 0. D is 1, G is 0, but output will go 1. Both are zeros, D and G is 0, the output may turn into the previous condition itself, so it will retain 1. Now, after doing this flow table, we know when we want to write a primitive flow table, the variables have to be assigned with a steady state condition. So, we are going to assign a variable for every flow diagram. So, we'll have the flow diagram starting from here, A, B, C, D, E, F. Therefore, these are the states. These are the states. Now, coming to the flow table. Primitive flow table is summarized as A, B, C, D, E, F. These are the states we are going to go. So, write down the state. What is D and G? What is the output at that moment? A is 0, 1, 0. So, 0, 1, 0. B is 1, 1, 1. C is 0, 0, 0. Write down the same condition. D is 1, 0, 0. 1 0 1 1 0 1 finally 0 0 1 0 0 1. So from here you can find out, you have to write the comments. The comments have been taken from the problem statement. So A can go to C and C can go to D. So when D is equal to Q, G is equal to 1. When D is equal to Q, G is equal to 1. B can go to D, E and F. So, the C will occur after A state or after D state. And similarly, D can occur only after A state. only after A state, because 2-bit change is not allowed. Directly A to D is not allowed because 2-bit change is not allowed. So it will move from A to C first, then from C to D. See, a 0-1 is converted to 0-0, then 0 will be converted to 1-0. Next condition, 1-1 cannot directly go to 0-0, cannot go to BF. So you have to go to one statement 1-0, after that 0-0. So B will occur for the statement of E, B or F. But F will occur only after E, only after E. After the primitive flow table, I have written the primitive flow table 0-0-0-1-1-0-1-1-1. So A is assigned to 0-1. A is assigned to 0-1. You know that A is assigned to 0-1. B is assigned to 1-1. C is 0-0. E is 1-0. F is 0-0. So whenever A goes to the same state, it is a stable state condition. So you will encircle it. You will encircle it. When B is going to its own state, you will encircle. When C is going to the own state 0-0, it is encircled. Similarly, E goes to 1-0, it is encircled. So wherever you have these encircled, which indicates it's a stable steady state condition, and that condition output will be taken across the circuit. So in this, you will have how many states? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 states. But check out whether any redundant states are available. So compare the values. So C, this is a don't care. If these are there, which means that B is 1-1. If you want to go to 0-0, this is not possible. 2-bit change, therefore it is defined as an undefined variable. It is a don't care condition. Similarly, here it is a don't care condition. Here it is a don't care because A is 0-1. You cannot go to 1-0 directly. 2-bit change is not allowed. 2-bit change not allowed. 2-bit change is not allowed. 2-bit change, 2-bit change. Wherever you have a 2-bit change, there and all, it is defined as dash dash, which is defined as undefined variable or a don't care condition. So now you find out any variables are repeating. See here, the variables are same. A and B remains the same. C, don't care. A, B, B, E, don't care. So A, B can be compressed together. Similarly, A and C is also same. So A, C also can be compressed. A, D can also be compressed. Therefore, A, B, A, C, A, D all can be compressed together. So we go for the reduced flow table after this. To reduce the flow table, we are going to draw the implication table to find the compatible pairs. So after the primitive flow table, we go to implication table, which will help in going for the reduction in primitive pair table. So to draw your implication table, make sure that you leave the first row. The primitive table first row is negated. So your statement is only from B, C, D, E, F. The column is B, C, D, E, F. If I want to take on x-axis, eliminate the last row. The primitive flow table last row is eliminated. Therefore, the x-axis will become A, B, C, D, E. Now compare AB with your primitive flow table. Compare AC, compare AD. All three are compatible. So whenever they are equivalent, I've compared. See here, AB is equal, AC is equal, AD is equal. When all are equal, you put a tick mark in the implication table. Now compare A with E. A with E you compare. See, first itself is C state, F state. It is different. Even one state is different, the compatible is not happening. So you put a cross mark. I put a cross mark saying C and F are there, it is not compatible. Similarly, A to F, the same thing, C and F are there in the primitive flow table, it is not compatible. I have done it for B, I have done it for C, I have done it for E. Okay, E, everything I have done it. So wherever you have a tick mark, it's compatible. All the states are equivalently equal. If one statement is also not equal, then you put a cross mark. I put a cross mark and I mentioned that it is not equal. So wherever you have a tick mark, these tick marks are called as compatible pairs. I have written A, B, A, C, A, D. B, E, B, F. D, F. E, F, C, D. So these are the compatible pairs. So once you draw the compatible pairs, we are going to go for the merger diagram. Merger diagram are nothing but a circular which says about two you're going to take a compatible pairs and then mark it in a pictorial representation. So compatible pairs in a pictorial representation graph is called as merger diagram. So this merger diagram is made up of a circle, and you write down all the states A to F. Write down all the states A, B, C, D, E, F. Now use this compatible pairs. A is going to B. A is going to B. A is going to C. A is going to D. Use the compatible pairs. Then B is going to E. B is going to E. B is going to F. C is going to D. C is going to D. E is going to F. E is going to F. After you have drawn this, find out how many triangles are present. How many close loop? How many triangles are present? So you have one triangle BEF. You have the next close path ACD. So triangle ACD and triangle BEF. These are the two closed paths. So this can be merged. ACD can be merged into a single variable A. BEF can be merged into a single variable B. Therefore, you can replace C and D. Wherever C and D is coming, you replace A. Wherever B and F are coming, you replace by B statement. This is called as the reduced flow table, primitive flow table. So now you can write down from the sixth state, from six states, A, C, D is reduced to A. B, E, F is reduced to B. So instead of having six, I have reduced it to three states separately, three states separately. Into three states separately, A, C, D, and similarly B, E, F. Write down the three separate states from the primitive flow table. Take it separately. Take A separately, C separately, D separately. Write it down. Similarly, take B separately, E separately, F separately. Write it down. Okay. After you have written down, you can map now. A, C, D is made into single row. B, E, F is made into single row. Combine this. Wherever you have C element, replace A. C replace A. D replace A. D replace A. Therefore, it will become C is A, B, D. You can see. A, B, D, A, B, D. And similarly, B, E, F. Wherever you have E, F, E and F, merge it into B. So you'll have the statement B, A, B, A. B, A, B, B. You have the statement. Okay. After you have the statement, now we need to go for the transition. So transition tables are nothing but table where you are going to replace A, B, C states in terms of the binary values. Binary values. So maintain two tables will be obtained. One is going to be with respect to the binary variables A, B. This table, this particular K-map is only with A and B parameters. A, B is replaced with binary values. And this table is representing the output. This table is representing the output. This table is representing the output. So I've drawn the K-map. Okay. Then you combine two flipping, combine, write down the equation. These are called the synthesized equation or a state equation. After you have drawn it, the final step is come out with the logical diagram. So it is DG YG bar. DG G bar. Y is from the feedback. So this is a sequential circuit. Feedback delay element. I've attached D and this is Y given to an OR gate. So this is the Y. Q, whenever a stable state condition is occurred, this Y will be turned into Q output. So this is how we design a pulse mode circuit. So this D and G are nothing but your D latches. Thank you.